We will first talk about the polar form of a complex number and exponential form, because these forms are, especially the exponential form, is extremely useful in solving the multiple choice questions. Okay. We are going to define the following function. All of us are aware of e to the power x, our exponential function, whose derivative is e raised to x and so is its integral. We are going to define the following function, e to the power I theta, where theta is any real number. Okay. Now, you do not have the differentiation and integration of such functions. This is a function of a single complex variable. Isn't it? Because you have I there. Although theta is a real number, e to the power I theta is a complex number. So if you treat the variable to be I theta, then it will be a function of a single complex variable. Just like you have differentiation and integration of functions of real variable, you also have differentiation and integration of complex variables in engineering as well as in BSc maths or BSc physics. Okay, so there you need the differentiation or the methods to differentiate complex functions. Okay, the other example of a function of single complex variable would be z squared or square of x plus I, and just now we discussed the root. So all of them, sine z, cos z. Okay, if you remember, I told you hyperbolic functions. Sine h is, I would say sine h of x and cos h of x. Okay, so all these functions have a special connection with the exponential form of a complex number. I think I told you this when we solved examples of that kind in, I think, in differential equations. But anyways. So, what is a polar form of a complex number? We consider the complex number z, which is equal to x plus I y. Okay. And we say that the modulus of z is r and the principal argument of the complex number is theta. Okay. So, now you can prove that z is also equal to r cos theta plus I into R sine theta, or in short you can say R common cos theta plus I sine theta. So this is basically the same thing which I told you here. What polar coordinates tell us, R and theta, that is nothing but the modulus of the complex number and the argument of the complex number, and we have the transformation equations from Cartesian to polar and polar to Cartesian. X is r cos theta and y is r sine theta. So this is what basically we write here. X r cos theta, y r sine theta. If you take r common, you will get cos theta plus I sine theta. So that is the polar form of the complex number, and exponential form of complex number is this. The expression cos theta plus I sine theta, or the complex number cos theta plus I sine theta, is actually equal to e to the power I theta, and this is known as Euler's identity. E to the power I theta is equal to cos theta plus I sine theta. You can prove this by a special series which we call Maclaurin series, which is a power series in theta, But as of now, you just remember that e to the power I theta is cos theta plus I sine theta. So the exponential form of the complex number is this. Z equals r e to the power I theta. And the polar form of the complex number z equal to x plus I y is this. Okay? So that completes polar form and exponential form. We have already talked about the modulus and the amplitude.